That is DCA 1. So he will take first block. So I request Bhavesh sir to start the class.
Thank you and welcome to our moderator sir Himadri Bhushan Mahapatra and technical supported madam Ms. Sagarika Mishra and many thanks and welcome again to our dear learners. Today we will cover or start the topic is computer fundamentals, that is DCA 1. Okay, sir, audible? Hello.
Yes, sir, audible, sir.
Hello.
Audible.
Okay, thank you. what is computer? What is computer? Generally or basically we know. What is computer? Computer is a generally or basically we know computer is an electronic device. So that is or a computer system is a set of integrated devices that input, output, process and store data with
sir,
information.
स्क्रीन टा माने इटा प्रेजेंटेशन टा व्यू होनी देखा जाउनी प्रेजेंट अछि ताको मिनिमाइज करंतु सेरा को ऑन करंतु स्क्रीन को मिनिमाइज शेयरिंग हे छि प्रेजेंट होउ छि Dear learner, due to some technical problem, okay, we'll start very soon. So, sir is sharing his screen. So, please wait, we'll start. Okay, so today, sir, we'll take class on computer fundamental. Yes, sir, Asuji.
Sir, it is visible.
Yes, yes, visible.
Okay, thank you. Sorry, due to technical problem, so we have.
आपणको presentation टा. हाँ.
Sir, ये presentation आपणको रो कर
दीजिए. Hello, Abhijit Pradhan. Sir, now visible?
Visible, but your presentation is not visible. Your screen is visible, but presentation is not visible.
Okay, okay. Just Himadri sir, I request you, please just 1 minute you arrange and introduction to learner. I have just between okay. 1 minute I have joined.
Okay, okay, okay. So dear learner, today sir will take class on computer fundamental. So basically computer fundamental in your chapter or in your course, there are the different blocks are there. So in first blocks, it is information about computer, that is information of computer, information about input device, output device, processing device, what are the different application of computers. So all the things will be discussed in this session. So I'll sir
connect kar do tumara. Okay, okay sir.
Okay. Okay, so I think there is some technical problem. So sir will connect very soon. So we'll discuss something about some parts about computers. What is computer? What are the different input device and output device? So first thing is computer. What is a computer? First, in first chapter, first your in first chapter there should be what do you mean by a computer? Computer means mane kon computer ta kon computer is a processing device. Simply jodi ame kahiba computer is a processing device, electronic processing device. Tapare jodi ame aga ku padhiba it will Okay, so first we'll discuss the definition of computer. What is a computer? Okay, so a computer system is a set of integrated devices that input, output, process, and store the data and information. Computer systems are currently built around at least one digital processing device. There are five main hardware components in a computer system, that is input, processing, storage, output, and communication device. Basically, what happened? Computer is a set of integrated device, not one device, that is an integrated device. Integrated device means it is a combination of different devices, that is input devices, output devices, processing devices. And so we'll discuss one after another. First, we'll discuss what is an input devices. Yes, sir. Bhavesh, sir. Okay. So first, we'll discuss what is an input device. Input devices means through which we'll give the input to the process, to the computer. Okay.
Sir.
Yes.
More directly to the hai paru nahi.
Okay, I am sharing the screen.
Okay. Okay. You share the screen. Okay, and I will discuss here. Okay. Sir, audible? I will start here.
Okay.
Dear learner, very sorry, due to technical problem, we are not able to joining the proper time. Excuse. Okay, thank you. What is the definition of computer? Computer is an electronics device. Basically, we all are known. Then, a computer system is a set of integrated devices that input, receive input, give output, process, and store data and information. Computer systems are currently built around at least one digital processing device. Okay? Then, then, basically, five main hardware components in a computer system. What is this? Five hardware components, what? Input, processing, storage, output, and communication. Okay, then common uses of computer. Common uses computer means we are uses at study time, solving mathematical problem, watching TV, movies, listening to music, playing games, etc. Then communicating with other people through email, through chatting, sending email, receiving email, using the internet, etc. It is a basic common uses of computer. Sir, Himadri sir, I request you please share the
sir, sharing screen. Permission maguchi. Ekto share hai paruni, share Audible, permission sir. Maguchi. Ha, yes. Sharing permission maguchi etu.
Hello.
Sir, sharing hai paruni etu.
ओके ओके
ओके
मो वॉइस टा ऑडिबल हो छी आपन को प्रॉपर्ली
वॉइस इज ऑडिबल प्लीज गो ऑन
ओके ओके थैंक यू lastly we share the screen okay try just a minute okay just a minute I will try to share the screen
आसिला सर
ओके थैंक यू फॉर योर कोऑपरेशन ओके ओके just like please see and visit just like common uses of computer basically already I am discussing about this playing computer games writing solving math problems communication with other people and basically for you it is a diagram for use of computer educational field just like business hospitals banking government offices home marketing students etc okay then basically we know and we saw this seen this computer uses a hospital just like one patient as a expiration time that is breathing heartbeat breathing the patient just like a diagram of you the ultrasound systems ECG just like modern computers defined what is modern computer modern computers are electronic and digital the actual machinery wires transistors and circuits is called hardware the instructions and data are called software memory enables the computer to store at least temporarily data and program who is designed the computer who is designed all are known hand mathematician Charles Babbage designed a Victorian era computer called the analytical engine. This is a portion of the mill with a printing mechanism. First, Charles Babbage creating the computer system. Due to network problem, my presentation properly not visible to you. After class, definitely I will share it. Okay. 1822 approximately, English mathematician Charles Babbage consists of a system driving it just like calculating machine that would be able to compute tables of numbers. Then, characteristics of computer. What is characteristics of computer? Characteristics computer is different types. Basically, we will discuss, we will know 8 types. First is speed. S-P-E-E-D, speed. What is speed? You know, computer can work very fast. It takes only few seconds for calculation that will take hours to complete. You will be surprised to know that computer can perform millions of instructions and even more per second. Quick, meaning too fast, computers can solve many types of data, that is mathematically, arithmetically, logically, or any programming, very fast calculating that, or solve that problem. Therefore, to determine the speed of computer in terms of microsecond, 10 to 6 part of a second, or nanosecond, 10 to the power 9 part of a second. Formally, this you can imagine how fast your computer performs work. That is called speed. Next characteristics is accuracy. Accuracy means accurate, means correction, correct. How much correct? The degree of accuracy of computer is very high, and every calculation is performed with the same accuracy. The accuracy level is 7, determined on the basics of design of computer. The errors in computers are due to human and inaccurate data. Computer will give the wrong data, computer give the wrong output or wrong answer. We give the input, throw input, correct data, the exactly computer 100% accuracy give the output data. It is accuracy, definition of accuracy. It is very important and necessity for learners. Characteristics of a computer is a very important course. Please mind it. And you got questions from this. Then, diligence. what is meaning of diligence? Diligence basically careful and persistent work of effort. How carefully tackled this work from Gita, from Rishi to human. Computer is free from tiredness, no feeling tired, lack of concentration, fatigue, etc. It can work for hours without any error. If millions of calculations are to be performed, a computer will perform every calculation with the same accuracy. Due to this capability, it overpowers human being in routine type of work, etc. Basically, diligence means careful and persistent work of the person. Next, versatility. What is the meaning of versatility? V-E-R-S-A-T-I-L-I-T-Y, versatility. Means able to change easily or to be used for different purposes. Basically, at a time, we are doing multiple work. Just like typing a letter, in the meantime, we give a email, receive email, etc. That type of work, multiple work. Versatility, it means the capacity to perform completely different type of work. Completely different type of work. You may use your computer to prepare payroll slip, just like a company. Next moment, you may use it for inventory management or to prepare electricity bill, etc., just like. That is able to change easily or to be used for different purposes. Okay. Then, next characteristics. Power of remembering. What is power of remembering? Capacity of recall or remembering. Computer has a power of storing any amount of information or data. Any amount, or small or large, data and information. Any information can be stored and recall as long as you require. Any information can be stored and recalled as long as you require it. For any numbers of year, month, week, etc. It depends entirely upon you how much data you want to store in a computer and when to loss or retrieve this data. So that is power of remembering. Next one, storage. Capacity of storage. The computer has an inbuilt memory. Inbuilt memory in the sense inside of computer available in the memory. Computer has an inbuilt memory where it can store a large amount of data. You can also store data in secondary storage device, such as, you know, floppy disks, CD disks, pen drive, hard disk, etc., which can be kept outside your computer and can be carried to other computers. That is called storage. Now, the next one. No feelings. What is the meaning of feelings? No sadness. No emotional. No everything. That's feelings. Okay. What is no feeling? It does not have any feelings or emotion. It is definition. Taste, knowledge, and experience, just like. Thus, it does not get tired even after long hours or work. It does not distinguish between users. So, just like we are doing hard work, after some time we feel tiredness or sadness, or successfully completed that work, that is, we feel happiness. So, just like computer, no feelings. It is a machine. Okay, thank you. Next one. No IQ. No IQ. What is no IQ? IQ means we are human. So, we have brain. And we recall it. But computer depend on fully human. Human give any instruction that they are doing that type of work. The computer is a dumb machine and it cannot do any work without instruction. Without instruction, that cannot be any work from the user. It performs the instruction at tremendous speed and with accuracy. It is due to, okay, good, very good. It is due to decide what you want to do and it what sequence. So computer cannot take its own decision as you can. Computer is a machine. It's running or working from instruction of human. Okay, thank you. Complete the characteristics of computer. 8 characteristics, that is speed, accuracy, diligence or subtlety, power of remembering, no IQ, no feelings, then storage. Okay. You see, basically, 4 types of computer. For functions of a computer system. So that is data input, data processing, information output, and data and information storage. Again, I repeat it. Basically, four functions of a computer: data input, data processing, information from output, and lastly, data and information storage. Himatri sir,
yes,
just
sir.
1 minute. I will try.
Sir, it is already shared.
I am not visible. Learners,
yes,
visible or not?
Yes,
no.
You are visible.
I am not visible. Okay. You are sharing, sir?
I have already shared and it is visible also.
Okay. Good, very good. ताले सर मुरी कनेक्ट है कि प्रेजेंटेशन करी भी नहीं प्रॉब्लम पूरा ड्यू टू व्हिच टेक्निकल प्रॉब्लम ओके
यस सर कैन आई स्टॉप द शेयरिंग
नो सर यू कंटिन्यूइंग because I have a problem.
Okay. So you continue.
Okay, sir. I am continuing. Okay. Basically, I say four functions, that is data input, data processing, information output, data and information storage. Okay. Input basically depend on keyboard, mouse through keyboard, scanner, trackball, etc. It is a input device. Output device, what is output? Our monitor, we see our monitor is a output device. Touch screen, what is touch screen? We know, we are all known, just like ATM machine, is a touch screen. Printers is a output device. Speaker, output device. Definition of input device. We know input device is a keyboard, mouse, scanner, etc. What is the definition of input device? Input devices are hardware devices that allow data to be input into a computer. For example, just like keyboard, mic, barcode reader, etc. Those are input devices. Processing. What is processing? Processing is hardware in a computer is accountable for storing and retrieving information. This information is processed using the central processing unit, that is called CPU, Central Processing Unit. This part of the computer takes information that is inputted by the user and process the information by calculating, comparing, and copying and is then saved to the computer's memory. Computer's memory is RAM, that is random access memory, RAM. It is a processing system for memory. Then we go to output. Output is a just like speaker, printer, mic, etc. It is a definition. The devices which are used to display the data, just like a monitor. It is a display the data. Monitor is the output device. Data to the user, either in the form of hard copy or soft copy, are called output device. Printout, any letter pages printout is an output device. Output device are pieces of hardware that are used to display or output data, which has been processed or has been stored on the computer. Then classifications of computer. Classification of computer means basically we know three types of computer basically. That is a analog computer, digital computer, and hybrid computer. Just give example one. On the basis of size, just 1-2 minutes discuss regarding computer. On the basis of size, we'll discuss sizes, microcomputer, mini computers, mainframe computer, and supercomputer. On the basis of size, I'll discuss. Basis of data, just like we are knowing and uses, that is analog computer, digital computer, and hybrid computer. Basis of brand, what's basis of brand? Just like IBM computer, Apple, Manchester, etc. It is a basics of computer. Basic purposes. What is the purposes? General purpose of computer, scientific purpose of computer. Then we will discuss analog computer. What is analog computer and where it used or uses? Analog computers were widely used in scientific and industrial applications even after the advent of digital computers. Basically, it is uses specific applications, aircraft flight simulators, flight computer in aircraft, and for teaching control system in universities. Analog computer or analog computer is a type of computer that uses the continuously changeable aspects of physical phenomena such as electrical, mechanical, or hydraulic quantities to model the problem in solve. It is a analog computer uses. Then digital computer. Digital computer basically commonly we are used, but that is digital computer. Digital computer, the input data is presented by a number, a computer that processes information in digital form, just like digital form 0 and 1, type numerical, ABCD, etc. The computer which present physical quantities with the help of symbols or numbers and provide us discrete information are called digital computer. It is main advantage, it is accuracy, best accuracy given. Output result is best accuracy. What is hybrid computer? Hybrid computer are computers that exhibit features of analog computer and digital computer. The digital components normally serves as the controller and provides logical and numerical operations, while the above components often serves as a solver of differential equations and other mathematically complex equations. It is a bunch of a mixture of digital and analog. Hybrid computer has a speed of analog and the accuracy of digital computer. It is an advantage. Computer which have qualities of both digital and analog computers are called hybrid computer. Then generations of computer. Generations of computer is basically 5 generation. That is time period and technology we will discuss. Time period between from 2 and technology used. First generation computer. It is approximately 1946 to 1959. Technology is used vacuum tube. Then second generation, approximately year 1959 to 1965, approximately. It is technology uses, it is a developed from first generation computer, and technically technically uses of equipment, that is transistor. Then third generation computer. Third generation computer basically generally 1965 to 1971. Components or technology used integrated circuit, that is called IC. IC, that is short for integrated circuit. It is a technology used. Then fourth generation. Fourth generation is basically 1971 to 1980. components are used VLSI microprocessor. It is a microprocessor systems. Fifth generation generally used 1980 onwards. Basically, we use as digital computer. Technology uses ULSI microprocessor. Now we use this type of computer. First generation computers, some example, please mind it. It is a very important, just like first generation computer, basically five types of. I will discuss just simply because it is a very large, vast course, but simply I will discuss. That is called first generation computers. First, that is called ENIAC, 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 which stands for Electronic Numerical Integrator and Computer, that is ENIAC. Then developed some years between developed next computer, that is called EDVAC, 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 so that is for Electronic Discrete Variable Automatic Computer, that is EDVAC. Then UNIVAC, 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 it is stand for Universal Non-Integrated Vacuum Equipped Computer. That is, we have discussed the first generation computer is the vacuum tube, that is vacuum equipped computer. And it is a that computer, first generation computer, just like is a 10 by 12 or 15 feet room, exactly look like it is a first generation computer. So that time we just vacuum tube UNIVAC. Then IBM 701, that is International Business Machine. Next one, IBM 650, that is International Business Machine. It is a first generation of computers. Then, just simply I will discuss what is software used that time. Okay, first generation computer, it is machine language, that is 1 and 0, uses only software. Second generation computer, software uses Fortran, F-O-R-T-R-A-N, Fortran software. Third generation computer, time sharing and parallel processing software are uses. Fourth generation computer, multiprocessor, operating system OS, compiler environments for parallel processing, data software uses. The fifth generation, just like we are using now, massively parallel processing, all programming, all software, etc. that uses. Then advantage and disadvantage of first generation computer. What is advantage and what is disadvantage? Advantage is these computers were the fastest calculating device of their time. They could perform computation in millisecond, which is advantage. Disadvantage is maximum. Too bulky in size, just like I give example, required one room just like 10 feet and 15 feet or 12 feet room size. It is a big machine. Too bulky in size. Unreliable. It's not reliable because current failure, current is failed, total data is failed. Unreliable. Thousands of vacuum tube that we are used emitted large amount of heat and burned out frequently. Frequently, with maximum time, it is maximum heated, heat generated and burned. Air conditioning required because vacuum tube maximum time generated the maximum heat. So air condition is must be required. It is a disadvantage. Not portable. It is a bulky, not portable. Then second generation computer, so advantage and disadvantage. Smaller advantages, it is a, just like smaller from first generation computer. It is a not minimum smaller, it is a just smaller from first generation computer. It is a smaller in size, more reliable, used less energy and were not heated, wider commercial use, maximum commercial or business purposes and persons are used, better speed and could calculate data in microseconds, use faster peripherals like tape drives, magnetic disks, printer, etc. Used assembly language instead of machine language, and accuracy improved. Accuracy means accurate or correctness. What is disadvantage second generation? Cooling system is required, means AC, air condition is required to just a room. Constant maintenance was required. It is a maximum time failure, the board, main board failure, so constant maintenance was required. Commercial production was difficult. Parts of computer is maximum rate, so it is commercial production was difficult. Only used of specific purpose. Some persons use only specific, most essential cases. Uses. Costly and not versatile. Polestar were used for input. It is a disadvantage of second generation. Then we come to third generation. Third generation is a, it is a smaller in size, which is advantage. Smaller in size, more reliable, better speed, could calculate data in nanoseconds, totally general purposes, good storage capacity, less expensive, better accuracy, and commercial production increased. Maximum persons are used this. Used mouse and keyboard for input. Third generation computer, basically input device are used as keyboard and input. It is a main advantage. Disadvantages, highly sophisticated technology required for the manufacturing of IC chips. IC, that is called integrated chip. It is a high cost, and some sophisticated technology they are manufactured. And air conditions, means AC room, AC is required. It is a disadvantage. Then fourth generation. Fourth generation computer, maximum advantage we see the maximum advantage. What advantage? Smallest in size due to the use of very large scale integration. So that is called short form VLSI. Heat generation was negligible because first generation computer not uses vacuum tube. So it is a heat generation capacity is less. Hardware failure was negligible because motherboard for motherboard cooling facilities for motherboard is available there. So hardware failure is negligible. Easily portable. It is a small size, so easily transportable for hardware maintenance was very rare. Computation were performed fastly. Computer were cheapest. Price is low. Maximum persons are purchased it and used it. It is advantage. Disadvantage, highly advanced technology was required to manufacture very large scale. First generation computers which require very large software. That is a disadvantage for purchasing cost. Then we are used but presently continuing fifth generation of computer. Fifth generation computer 1989 basically 1989 to till that. It is advantage. What is advantage? Fifth generation computer. Fastest and power computer till that. Very fast, you know. Able to execute a large number of applications to very high speed. Very high speed. So that is just like fifth generation computer, we are doing this. P3, P4, P5, laptop, board processor, etc. It is an advantage. ULSI technology helps in decreasing the size of computer. It is a very small size. Now, fifth generation computer, the size is very minimum size. Multimedia features are available. Resource sharing is possible and is highly versatile. It is a basically advantage. The disadvantage, what is disadvantage? Disadvantage only one, not maximum disadvantage. Lack of human like intelligence. Next, we are basically desktop, laptop, notebook, notepad, huge body too. That is a basically fifth generation computer. Computer memory measurement. Computer memory means computer brain measurement. How we measure the computer memory? Just like example, you know, 1 bit, BIT bit, 1 bit. So that is called binary digit, 1 bit. 4 bit, 8 bit, 1024 bits, just like measure. Units of computer memory measurement. 8 bits, BITS, 8 bits equal to 1 byte. byte, byte. 1024 bytes. 1024 bytes equal to 1 KB by kilobytes. It is a short question, just one mark question. It is 1024 KB kilobyte equal to 1 MB. 1024 MB equal to means MB means megabyte equal to 1 GB by gigabyte. 1024 GB, gigabyte equal to 1 TB, just like user's computer memory. Okay. Components of computer. Basically, we know three types of components. One is input. Then processing unit, then output. It is basically three components. Input device, what is? Already I am discussed, just simply I will discuss you just briefly idea. Input device, input is any data that we send to a computer for processing. Through keyboard, mouse, scanner, digital camera, camcorder, joysticks, etc. Output device, what is? Output is the result of the processed data that we see through some device. Example, monitor, printer, speaker, etc. Then cache memory. Cache memory. What is cache? Cache means receive. Cache memory. Cache memory holds a copy. Holds a copy of the instructions. Instruction cache or data. Data means operand or data cache currently being used by the CPU. Cache memory, it is a receive the data and hold the data and process through CPU. Cache memory is a small high speed RAM, that is random access memory, RAM buffer located between the CPU and main memory. It is a cache memory. The main purpose of a cache is to accelerate your computer while keeping the price of the computer low. It is a cache memory. Cache memory, basically, it is a collection of items of the same type stored in a hidden or in accessible place. So that is cache memory. Hidden or inaccessible. Types of cache memory. Basically, we know two types, that is memory cache and disk cache. Memory cache, just like I said, it is a RAM, random access memory. Just like memory cache, sometimes called a cache store or RAM cache, is a portion of memory made of high speed static RAM. That is, static RAM means SRAM, short for me, SRAM, static RAM. Instead of the slower and cheaper than dynamic RAM or DRAM, used for main memory. Memory caching is effective because most programs access the same data or instructions over to over by keeping as much of this information as possible in SRAM, that is static random access memory, SRAM. The computer avoids accessing the slower DRAM. So basically, both are helping there, that is RAM, SRAM, or RAM, DRAM. SRAM hala static random access memory, dynamic random access memory. Then disk cache. What is disk cache? Disk is just like your CD disks, hard disks, etc. Disk caching are under the same principle as memory caching, but instead of using high speed SRAM, that is static RAM, the disk cache uses conventional main memory, the most recent accessed data from the disk, as well as adjacent sectors, is stored in a memory buffer. When a program needs to access data from the disk, it first checks the disk, gets to see if the data is there. Disk caching can dramatically improve the performance of applications because accessing a byte of data in random access memory, that is RAM, can be times faster than accessing a byte of a hard disk. It is a disk cache memory. Then hard disks. Hard disk is a main disk or main storage device of our computer. It's a hard disk. You know, hard disk, all are known. What is hard disk? A hard disk drive is a sealed unit that a PC uses for non-volatile data storage. Hard disk is a non-volatile data storage. And hard disk drive contains digit, disk-shaped platters, usually construct of aluminium or glasses. It is a construct. Non-volatile or semi-permanent storage means that the storage device retains the data even when no power is supplied to the computer. Unlike floppy disks, the platters cannot bend or flex, hence the term of hard disk. Hard disk is a main drive of our computer system. Then control unit. What is control? How we control data? Control unit controls operations of other parts of CPU as well as all parts of computer by sending a control signal. Look like that is control sequence of instruction to be executed, control flow of data among all parts of computer, interpret instructions, regulate timing of processors, send control signal and receive control signal from peripheral device. It is a control unit. Control means four data processing to control it. Then arithmetic logic unit, subconscious ALU, arithmetic logic unit. I am totally going through our module course. Please look and follow the module. Then arithmetic logic unit. What is logic unit? But arithmetic logic unit, ALU. Part of the computer that actually performs arithmetic and logical operations of data. Just 1 second, please.
Dear learner, if any questions, then you can put on the chat box. We will discuss at the end of the session. I request all the learners to put their question. We will discuss at the end of the session. Thank you. Sir, tike noise bahut asuchi. Kemiti?
Sir, noise asuchi?
Haan. Thau.
Maybe sir, fan ta subutuwa. Okay, thank you. Arithmetic and logic unit. What is arithmetic logic unit? Part of the computer that actually performs arithmetic and logical operations on data. Based on the use of simple digital logic device that can store binary digits and perform simple Boolean logic operations, that is arithmetic logic. All of the other elements of the computer system are there mainly to bring data into the ALU for it to process and then to take the results back out. So that is work of functions of ALU. Secondary storage. What is secondary storage? Definitions. What is secondary storage? Memory is secondary storage. Just like CD drive, floppy disks, pen drive, external hard disks, all are secondary storage. So definitions. Secondary storage devices refers to storage device that are not constantly accessible by a computer system, such as external hard drive, CDs, DVDs, etc. These are must be either plugged in or inserted into the computer in order to be accessed by the system. There are definitions of secondary storage. Then we have come virtual memory. It is very important. Virtual memory. What is virtual memory? Virtual memory is a technique that allows the execution of process that may not be completely in memory. So that is virtual memory. Advantage what is the advantage of virtual memory? Why we virtual memory? Program can be larger data than physical memory. Program can be larger than physical memory. It is advantage. Disadvantage is not easy to implement. And decrease performance if it is used clearlessly. It is a disadvantage. Two disadvantages, that is not easy to implement. Decrease performance if it is used clearlessly. Advantage is program can be larger than physical memory. Okay. Then external storage. What is external storage? We give the example, we know pen drive, CD drive, etc. External storage. External storage device perform the same functions as internal storage device to permanently store data. The only real difference is that external storage devices are easily to disconnect. From the computer in order to be mapped and used somewhere else. It is. External storage device include external hard disks and memory sticks. External storage device normally use USB to easily connect or disconnect from the computer. It is an external storage. Its advantage and disadvantage. Advantage is provide faster data, access and data transfer. It is faster data access and data transfer. They do not generate noise exactly, nor any sound, that is noise. They do not generate noise. Security, allowing a very quick scan of all data stored. It is advantage. Some of the storage devices are waterproof. Basically, waterproof means it's a data cannot be lost. Disadvantage. What is disadvantage? Price by cost. Solid state drives are more expensive than magnetic hard drive. It is a high cost. Recovery of data in case of failure can be more difficult than magnetic hard drive. It is a true disadvantage. Recovery of data in case of failure can be more difficult than magnetic hard disk, hard drive. Price, it is a cost, cost is high. Solid state drives are more expensive than magnetic hard drive. It is a disadvantage. We are all are well known pen drive. Pen drive, it is a widely used now our society. It is a just why we use pen drive, just simply I define and features, some features I'll tell you. USB plus drive is a data storage device that includes flash memory with an integrated universal serial bus USB interface. USB plus drive are typically removable and rewritable and physically much smaller, very small, much smaller than an optical. Okay, some features. These products are made by plastics. Color of this pen drives is white and purple. Length of pen drive is 5.5 cm. The capacity of pen drive is 8 GB, 16 GB, 32 GB, etc. The thickness pen drive is 1 cm only. Width of pen drive is 2 cm or 2 cm. It is a feature. Characteristics. What is characteristics of pen drive? Characteristics are able to store large amount of data. Large amount of storage data in small chip. Data such as pictures, songs, files, etc. We are store and transfer it quickly. But to go anywhere because it is smaller, be connected to a device that has a USB port. It is a some characteristics of a pen drive. External hard disk. We know hard disks, all are known hard disks, but external hard disk. What is external hard disk? Why we use? External hard disk or drive is an external hard disk or drive is a type of hard disk or drive which is connected from the outside to a computer. That is an external hard disk drive. Then come Google Drive or cloud storage. Google Drive and cloud storage. Google Drive and cloud storage both are approximately equivalent. For example, now we are joining the meeting and through Google Drive we are recording here, you know, recording all picture, all voice, everything, all are directly through internet connection. We are store data from Google Drive. It is a Google Drive storage, Google Drive and cloud storage. The Google Drive, you can quickly view many file types online, through online, including PDF, Microsoft Office file, and many other files type. You can view file that you upload or sync to Google Drive as long as it's 25 MB or less. To view file, click on the file title in Google Drive on the web or by following any link shared with you. Here some things you can do from the Google Drive. Revision history of the file. Revision history of the file, if you have honor or edit write from Google Drive. Change the sharing setting if you have owner or edit write. Download and print by going to the file menu and selecting downloads as search text on the page using the search box in the upper right corner. You look and go from this email. Add your comments in all types of file, etc. Cloud storage refers to the service in which user data is remotely maintained, managed, as well as backed up or stored. The service is usually available to the users over internet. In this concept, user will store the files online using internet to the external servers maintained by the cloud storage service provider. Once the file are stored, these can be accessed from anywhere in the world with the use of internet. It is a basic. Cloud storage provides user ease and convenience to handle the data backup and retrieval. User need not have to keep pen drive or carry hard disk along with him. But this will often add to the cost of the users to utilize the cloud storage service for large amount of data storage. Moreover, cloud storage is much slower compared to local storage backup for the huge amount of data. It is the basic of cloud storage. Components of computer, they basically I will discuss SMPS as per your model course. What is SMPS? That is switch mode power supply. It is a main part of computer. The term of SMPS, switch mode power supply, is defined as when the power supply is involved with the switching regulator to change the electrical power from one from to another, from which required characteristics is called SMPS, switch mode power supply, SMPS. This power supply is used to achieve regulated DC direct current output voltage from the DC input voltage or unregulated AC by alternating current. Just like just an example, SMPS stands for switch mode power supply. Its job is to convert one voltage AC power, AC means alternative current, AC power to lower voltage DC power. Most computer chips, each modern computers require power. So basically we are using now this type of computer. Power is the generated neighborhood of 1.2 to 3.3 volt with some older device, that is an old computer device, requiring between 5 to 12 volt DC. It is a great work of SMPS. Control total electricity. What are the advantage of SMPS. Switchboard power supply provide improved efficiency and space saving of our traditional liner supplies, but KR has 2-bit account to ensure noise on the output is low. Switch mode power supply are widely used because of the advantage they offer in term of size, weight, cost, efficiency, overall performance. Then motherboard. It is a main board, just like a hat. Motherboard. What is motherboard? Main of the board are called motherboard. Computer motherboard serves as a single platform to connect all of the parts of a computer together. Understand? All components are connected from motherboard. All components. Platform to connect all of the parts of a computer together. It connects the CPU, that is called Central Processing Unit, CPU, memory, hard disk drive, optical drivers, video card, sound card, and other parts, records, and expands card directly or via cable. It can be considered as the backbone of a computer. It can be considered as the backbone of a computer. Okay. What is the main purpose of motherboard? Motherboard, also known as the main board, in the central circuit hub that allows connection between all components and peripherals attached to the computer. It also allows all the components such as CPU, graphic card, hard disk drive, and many the memory to receive power from the attached power supply. Types of motherboard. Motherboards, many types of motherboard have now available. So, but I have some example, just 6, 7, 8 types of motherboard. Motherboard comes in different size and types, known as form factor. The most common motherboard form factor is ATX. The different type of ATX are known as micro ATX, sometimes shown as mini ATX, flex ATX, EATX, watts, nano ATX, pico ATX, and mobile ATX. Basically, we use now nano ATX, pico ATX, and mobile ATX. Himadri sir.
Yes sir. Yes.
Okay, we are stop there.
Okay sir, okay, thank you.
So please stop and recording stop you from side.
Okay. Thank you sir. Thank you for a brief presentation. So I think there is no learner, so I'll request you. Now we will wind up our session, and thank you for all the participants to participate in the session. Thank you Sagarika ma'am for their technical support, and thank you Bhavesh sir for your beautiful presentation and session.
Thank you.
Thank you all. Now we'll wind up here. Thank you.
Many thanks to Sagarika ma'am and Himadri sir for your kind support. Many thanks.